Hey guys, Mark Hall here, and we are taking the Thrive Challenge. What we want to do is challenge each other to dig into God's Word together, to let God define some things for us. If you're not in the Word for yourself, you're going to make stuff up. You're going to figure out how far God's forgiveness goes, and how much He really can use you, and how many times He's really going to let you slide until He just zaps you or something. So you got to get into the Word for yourself. And what you see is when we draw that picture of the tree planted by streams of water, what we do in our youth group is we do this, dig in deep and reaching out, right? So there are a lot of believers that I would say maybe are just all roots. Man, they all want to know deeper and deeper stuff. They want to read new books by new preachers, and they don't like this preacher anymore because he doesn't do it like this one does. And they want to know all the new words and all the new theologies, but they don't love anyone. All they are is the roots. And that's just kind of useless. But then the other kind of believers you see out there, they're all reach. Man, they got just enough faith in them to know they're in, and they just want to go out and save the world. They want to love people and reach people and feed people and all these great things, which are awesome. But they don't have any roots. They're not in the Word for themselves. So the very first storm that blows through just knocks them right over. So what I believe God draws in His Word is a picture of somebody who's digging into the Word so they understand who God is and who they are now. And then they're, because of that, reaching out to the world. Yeah? Because you can't hang fruit. It's impossible. Fruit comes from within, right? And God, on purpose, calls the fruit of the Spirit. The Spirit of God in you is going to produce fruit in you. Your job is not to fruit. That's why it's not a verb, with other reasons too, but that still. So what you've got to do then is you get into the Word, see who God is, see who you are, and then just start trusting Him. And God's going to give you chances to surrender and love people or forgive people or share truth people or do this or that. But the fruit comes from Him. We tracking? So here's the challenge for this week. I want you to get into the book of James. James is awesome, 2.5 pages long. If a guy can say all he says in 2.5 pages, we need to hear from him, okay? And the very first verse in James is one we look over almost more than anything else. And he says, James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. James knows who he is. Do you know who you are? Are you a plumber, or are you an artist, or are you this? Are you something that you can do? Everybody nowadays is all built up on what they can do. And if you build your faith on how good you're doing this week, you're going to be toast next week. So what we're going to do is this week, I want you to walk through James in just a little bit at a time, chew on it. If you stay on YouTube and search for James Bible Study with Mark Hall or Casting Crowns, you'll find us. We'll stick the links down there. And just this week, walk through James with me, and let's keep thriving. See you guys next week.